During an interview this past weekend, former prosecutor Glenn Kirchner actually suggested that Jack Smith, the special prosecutor overseeing the DOJ's investigation into Donald Trump, might be looking at wire fraud charges against former President Donald Trump. Now, Kirchner explains, and of course we know all this, I'm not sure if everybody knows it, but here's what Kirchner explains. We know that in recent weeks, actually recent months, Jack Smith has been subpoenaing people with the Save America Political Action Committee. Save America is the political action committee that Donald Trump used to raise $250 million after the 2020 election. And he did that by, you know, basically spamming his supporters with emails saying, this election was taken from us. We have to fight in court to get it back. But in order to do that, you got to give us some money because I don't want to spend it out of pocket, right? That would be silly. No, send me your money and I'll fight this election with your money, not any of my money. And he raised $250 million doing that. Now, the problem is, as best we can tell from financial disclosure forms and all of that, and the lawsuit financing, he didn't spend any of that money on any of that. Like, literally $0 fighting the results of the 2020 election out of the $250 million that he raised. So, the big question is, would that constitute wire fraud? In an ordinary situation, if Donald Trump was not a politician, it would 100%. You're raising money under fraudulent pretenses and using them for something other than the stated purpose. You're defrauding people to cost them money. That is wire fraud. But with campaign finance laws, things get a little murkier. So if Smith wanted to hit Donald Trump with wire fraud charges, this would once again be another uncharted area. And it would open up every politician in this country, left and right, to potential wire fraud charges based on what they say in their fundraising emails. And I think that's a good thing. Like, I want Smith to go down this path, not just to have another thing to hit Donald Trump for, but maybe to bring a little bit of honesty to campaign finance. I mean, we're not going to get campaign finance reform anytime soon, so we may as well have a criminal aspect to it if you try to overstep the bounds. But let me read you what Kirchner said. Those are fairly easy charges to prove, talking about the wire fraud. So I have a feeling you could see a series of wire fraud charges, and what I would predict would be the larger charge of conspiracy to defraud the United States. Because remember, a federal judge in California ruled previously there was enough evidence or preponderance of the evidence that Donald Trump committed the crime of conspiracy to defraud the United States. So that would be where you would probably be able to grow the wire fraud charges from. Because the wire fraud was committed in order to further another crime, which was fraud against the United States itself. So that's where the campaign finance, you know, murkiness may become a little more clear and may not apply here, because if you're raising money to do something that was inherently illegal in the first place, fraud against the United States, then those campaign finance laws are not going to protect you. That's what Kirchner's explaining, and that's why it's not necessarily as murky as it may seem, but we'll see, right? We do know that Jack Smith is looking at it. We do know he's talked to the Save America people. He's looked at the money. The money is on his radar. We just have to wait and see if it's going to be a part of his criminal charges as well.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.